Bonjour, everyone. My name is Autumn Taylor, and after last week's startling discoveries about my artistic abilities, I decided to take it one step further. You know, one of the final bosses in Luigi's Mansion, the French artist. Well, I'm gonna be much better than that. So, let's get started. Today, we're gonna be recreating Starry Night by Vincent van Gogh. So, first we're gonna start the base layer of blue. Trust me, I know what I'm doing. Just blend this in, as Bob Ross would say. We need a little more blue. Let's just pick this up. Now don't worry about these dark spots. It just adds a little more definition to me. Alright, we have some nice brush strokes in this blue. We're trying to add the wispy little lines. Alright. I think that's a nice base coat of blue for now. Now we're going to add a little bit of a sketch. We're gonna start sketching out the mountain. Let's see. Fine lines for this mountain. I'm not going to go into that yet. Still doing good. Now. Alright. Then, over here, when this goes up into blue and then comes down back this way. Alright. Now, because I'm such a fantastic artist, this is probably going to be better than the original. Then, just like that. done with the outline of the mountain. There, we have the outline of the mountain. Now we need to do that little travel up into the blue. This will tell. Thin and skinny. A little bit more brown into the brush. There. We have the sketch of the mountain. Now it's all about the definition in the mountain. So we're going to need to paint some of those fine lines. Just a little bit more paint. And start doing alright. See, it's looking pretty good so far. Alright. Now, see, we colored in most of the mountain. But we gotta get these edges colored in too, so we'll start filling it in. You gotta make sure that you do professional brush strokes. An amateur would never get a piece like this. White spots, but if there's a little bit, it's fine, because we're going to do another coat of green over this brown. So, just want to get this. And then we'll work on this little skinny strip here. Perfect. We have the mountain. Now we have to start with base coat. So let's just sit that over there. We need to find the right brush. That always happens to an artist at some point. Now, we need to add that green. Try it off. Now, I've decided to let this mountain dry a little bit before I add any more green. So, we're going to add some more blue to the sky. First, you just want to kind of pat that paint on there, so that way you get the right amount. And then you want to start rubbing it in. More nice brush strokes. It kind of doesn't matter which way you brush the paint for this type of painting. We're going for a slightly whimsical all over the place. Alright, so I went ahead and filled in some more of the blue down here, so that we have more sky to work with. And I'm gonna go ahead and put some white into the sky. Square white now. First we have to dip that brush in water. Moistens the bristles. Like a nice white current curves down, goes behind this mountain, and then circles around. So we're going to go ahead and mix up the paint right here. Spread it out a little bit. Don't have too much paint on the brush. Alright. Comes down from about right here. It's okay if the white's not completely showing through because it's more of a white, light blue. Alright, other side. Back. Alright, let's see. Just add little pieces throughout, and then we'll start spreading it in. Brushing at different angles, it adds the brush stroke of the original.
Alright, I think we need to add a little bit of green to this.
went ahead and outlined the mountains in the background and added some more green and made this little church. Now, I think it's time for me to draw the moon up here. Alright, so we're gonna get this with the brush. Sure, that we put like a nice outline and we don't press down too hard because then it starts blending with the that. Now I know what you're going to say, and no, this does not look like Pac-Man. Outline. We just start putting paint over it. Alright, so I've added the stars into the sky, and now I'm going to start adding some white down here above these mountains. Outline. And we need to do the outline over here. Alright, now we gotta start. Hello. to grab up some of this light over here. I've decided that the buildings down here, they just don't look good. I don't know, I think it needs to be a field of grass. Buildings are so overrated. So, we're just painting this a nice emerald green mixed with a little bit of white. We're just going over all of this. I'm definitely not doing this because I don't know how. I'm doing it because it's what's best for the painting. Trust me, I know how to draw buildings. It's so easy. One of the first things you learn whenever you're painting. That's definitely why it's an amateur move. Buildings in a painting. Finished. We just have some final little touches to do after this. See how the ground from the mountain is beginning to blend into the green of the field. This is
exactly what we want. That's more definition. Go over that. Grab more. That's green. Now I'm just adding white little dots on mine to kind of capture that of the original. Just need to be a few more and I'm almost finished. Alright. Now, I think we're done. Here's the recreation of Starry Night by Vincent van Gogh. And as you see, we have the moon and the stars and the mountain. We eliminated the buildings for good reasons. And now we have this masterpiece. So, if you enjoyed that video and you want to see more like it, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. And if you want more content, click that subscribe button. I'll see you next week. Bye!